A lot of people have been asking how they can automatically buy and sell Solana tokens. So in this video, I'm going to show you four different ways that you can automate Solana token purchases. Before we get started, I want to stress that none of this is financial advice, and if you lose all your money, it's not my fault. The first way to automatically buy tokens is by setting up a Solana token sniper bot. I have created a video showing you in detail how to set up the sniper, and I will link that video in a card at the top right as well as the description of this video. Basically, a token sniper allows you to set up an automatic buy on a token that has not yet launched. When you set up the Solana sniper, you will be one of the first people to buy the token as soon as the token is launched, or the liquidity becomes available for trading, which is one of the best ways to get in early on a token. You can find tokens before they launch on websites called launch pads, which are token platforms for holding pre-sales. In most cases, you will not be able to participate in pre-sales without holding the native launchpad token, but they will usually make the token contract addresses available, and you can take those token addresses and set them up in your Solana sniper. There are some launch pads that don't have any requirements to participate in pre-sales. If you are interested in learning more about these launch pads, then drop a comment. The second way to automatically buy and sell tokens is through limit orders. I will link the card to that video in the top right and also in the description of this video. Limit orders might not be a new concept to you, but most low market cap Solana tokens are not listed on centralized exchanges, which means you won't have the ability or access to place limit orders. But there are some DEXs and trading bots that will let you place limit orders. These include, but are not limited to, Jupiter and the Solana trading bot, which I will show you how to set up. Link to the video in the description. Basically, with limit orders, the tokens are already being traded live on DEXs. The purpose of placing limit orders is similar to the reason for using a sniper, which is that you simply don't feel like watching the Solana tokens like a hawk. You can place two different types of limit orders, a limit order to buy and a limit order to sell. You give the trading bot or DEX the values that you want to buy or sell at, and the orders will sit in a queue waiting for the price you set to hit. Once the price is met, the limit order will automatically be executed. You can cancel your limit orders at any time or set an expiry date for limit orders. Keep in mind that if the token never reaches the price that you set, then the limit order will never be executed. The third way to automatically buy and sell Solana tokens is with DCA, which stands for dollar cost averaging. You can also place DCA orders on Jupiter DEX and Telegram bots like Solana Trading Bot. Link to the official Solana Trading Bot will be in the description. If you are not familiar with DCA, it's when you elect to spread out your buys over a period of time. You can set a time frame for as little as a couple of minutes to as much as a year or more. Let's go over a quick example of setting up a DCA order on Jupiter. So when you're on Jupiter, you just want to go to the top where the menu is and make sure you select DCA and then connect your wallet. And as you can see, I have already selected my tokens. So I've chosen Solana as the token that I will use to make the DCA purchase. And then the coin that I'll be buying or DCAing into is Costco Hot Dog. In the first box, you want to enter in the total amount of Solana that you want to use for the DCA. So I'll enter 1 Solana. And then we have to set up the details. So let's change this. You can select minute, hour, day, week, and month. So I'm going to select to DCA monthly. So every 1 month. And the DCA will be held over a period of 1 year. So that will be 12 orders. And then you will get the DCA summary. So in total, we'll be spending 1 SOL on this DCA. And then the 1 SOL is being divided by the 12 orders, which comes out to 0.083333 SOL. And we're going to receive Costco Hot Dog for each DCA order. And the order interval is what we set up. 1 month, So that looks correct. It's going to start immediately and it's going to end 1 year from today. So to start the DCA, all you need to do is left click on Start DCA. The idea is that you spread out your buys over a period of time and you don't have to guess when the best time to buy is. You will be buying at the average price over 1 year when dollar cost averaging. So some months you will buy at a low price and some you might buy at a higher price, but you are taking the guesswork out of buying. And over a period of time, your average buy price should be lower than the highest price or the price at when the DCA ends. If you are interested in learning more about the mechanics behind DCA, then drop a comment with the word DCA below. The fourth and final way to automatically buy and sell tokens is by using copy trading. This is probably one of the more dangerous ways to automatically buy and sell tokens, but it can also be the most profitable if you know what to look for. Remember that none of this is financial advice. Most people might relate this method to scams, because there are scammers that will ask you if you want to make a lot of money with copy trading. Then they will have you pump their bags while they sell out for a profit, which can still happen if you don't research and find your own wallets to copy trade. If anyone approaches you asking to help you copy trade, then run away. Basically, you need to do your own research. With copy trading, you need to go out and find profitable wallets to copy trade. Once you find profitable wallets, you want to take those wallets and enter them into a Telegram bot that supports copy trading. I will link a couple of good Telegram bots for copy trading in the description. Once you find profitable wallets, you need to set up copy trading in the Telegram bot. To do this, you simply want to paste in the wallet address of the crypto trader you wish to copy. Most likely, you do not want to copy their buy amounts though. Using trading bots like Solana Trading Bot, you can set up your copy trade buy amount to something more manageable. I suggest starting with a couple of dollars until you have built up more trust or profits using someone else's wallet. If you have any questions about the four methods that we have just went over, then leave a comment and I will do my best to answer or possibly create a video around your comment. If this tutorial was helpful, please like the video and subscribe to see more similar content.